I'm Lauren, a wildlife biologist.
I'm David, a wildlife filmmaker, and we're still on our adventure through Ethiopia. Now, ready to spot some wildlife.
We're traveling to the thriving Bale Mountains in preparation to spot the wolf.
From the barren, inhospitable terrain of the Danakil Depression, a faraway place, our adventure takes us south into wolf territory. The lands where the wolves wander.
We're on our way to the Bale Mountains. It's been quite the journey, and of course we're searching for the rare and elusive Ethiopian wolf, which we really hope to see, along with so many other endemic species of Ethiopia, including the Bale monkey, away down in the Herena forest. The Ethiopian wolves are specialised hunters of the giant mole rat, which we also hope to see in action. So we're about 2.5 hours out until we reach the headquarters of the mountain, and I am so excited.
Welcome to Bale Mountain. This is the beginning of the Bale Mountain.
Only here can you hear the fading howls of the world's rarest canid. Ethiopia is not well known for being leaders in species richness. The country is nourished with endemic mammals, birds, and plants, existing in only one geographic location. The Bale Mountains are one of Africa's largest and most biodiverse mountain refuges at approximately 2,200 square kilometers. Divided into three main zones, all connected, allowing for exceptional biodiversity to flourish. Biodiversity forms the backbone of viable, healthy ecosystems where each species has an important role to play, on which humans depend so heavily. Home to almost 19% of endemic flowering plants, including the giant lobelia of the plateau, standing over 10 meters tall with the ability to survive being frozen solid. The Forest of Honey, Herena Forest, home to the last beekeepers of Ethiopia. 600 families proudly using ancient beekeeping techniques honed over generations. Honey is the second biggest source of income after coffee. Harboring the endemic Herena tree, now listed as vulnerable due to the increasing threat of logging. Here we've just found a flat-necked chameleon who's exposing itself to the sun, changing colour already, trying to warm up. Once habitat to the wolf's cousin, the African wild dog. Sadly, no longer due to the population pressures of expanding human presence.
Tomorrow is the day where our real search for the Ethiopian wolf begins.
Thank you. it's time to push our vehicle and ourselves to their limits and climb up to the roof of Africa, which encompasses 80% of Africa's land above 3,000 meters, including the Seneti Plateau. It is here we hope to find the wolves. These elusive carnivores are highly specialized to life in the Ethiopian highlands, which has 3,000 kilos of rats per square kilometer. So we climb as high as we can to the summit in search of the specialized rodent hunters. We spot our first giant mole rat foraging using its continuously growing incisors. As they are prime delicacy for the wolves, we must be getting closer. A pair of ginger rufous ears stick out. The moment has finally arrived.
We found a wolf, one lone wolf roaming the plains. Our guide Ayuba spotted it. One single wolf out here. Alone, I think, getting ready to hunt. Amazing, completely amazing. They live in packs, but they hunt solitary. So you'll find them out here on their own looking for the giant mole rat, which is exactly why they're out during the day. They're diurnal, because their food source is diurnal.
Before our eyes stands the apex predator of the Afro-Alpine highlands, responsible for maintaining balance and overall health of the entire ecosystem. The wolf walks across the plateau with lean agility, master of the Afro-Alpine terrain.
Today has been incredible. There are no words. We're only at lunchtime. We've already seen four different wolves. And a very bumpy car journey. We are now going down.
Exhilarated from our encounters with Ethiopia's iconic predator, we didn't capture the essence of the wolf the way we wanted. We want to get closer. This means hiking, where no vehicle can go, to Webb Valley, 4,000 meters up.
Another day is done. I am absolutely exhausted, and I think Davi is too. The sun has not even set, and I'm definitely ready for bed. We're staying in a tent tonight, but it's all been worth it. It's not easy. Looking for the Ethiopian wolf has not been easy, but it's been incredibly rewarding. Unfortunately, the Ethiopian wolf is the next on list to become extinct, to lose its place on Earth. The Falkland Island wolf just went extinct, and the Ethiopian wolf is next.
Will we lose yet another irreplaceable wonder of our world, trotting down the road to extinction? These animals are not crying wolf, at risk of their howls fading forever from the Horn of Africa.
Follow us in our final episode to see how close we get to the wolves.